Our Quran has no contradictions. But let me tell you, in your Bible, on camera, the contradictions, the mistakes.
In Surah 2:256, let there be no compulsion in religion. And then it says in Surah 9:3, proclaim a grievous penalty to those who reject faith. The Quran was revealed on sticks, stones and bones.
Leaves.
Sticks, stones and bones and leaves.
And leaves.
Give me the chain of narration for the sticks, stones and bones, bro.
Either you have taken away 7 books from the Bible, that's why your Bible has 66 books, or the Catholics, they have added 7 extra books.
No. You're making a claim that Martin Luther took away so many books. You've not provided any evidence, bro. Bible mistakes, copyist mistakes, 66% of the Quran is misread. The Hussai Quran manuscript, Dr. Tayyar Al-Kulak says this is not Uthmic. Paris Petromolopoulos says 74% of the Quran is misread. Okay. This has been verified on Islamic Awareness, an Islamic site, and I've also verified it on a secular site called Quranic Corponia. Listen,
let me finish.
So, these ancient manuscripts, we don't have a full ancient manuscript of the Quran. They've been corrupted by, they have textual variants. So to say that it's been preserved and passed on and is perfect today is gobbledygook.
Our Quran has no mistakes, okay? Our Quran has no contradictions. But let me tell you, in your Bible, on camera, the contradictions, the mistakes in your Bible. Now, I'll give you one example. In the second book of Samuel, chapter 21, verse 8, it says, Michal, the daughter of Saul, she had how many children? She had 5 sons. In the same book, second book of Samuel, in a different verse, chapter 6, verse 23, it says, Michal, the daughter of Saul, up to her death, she never had children.
Okay.
So, which one is true?
Okay, did you notice he didn't read out the verse, all of the verse, clearly? I'm going to read out some verses clearly from the Quran. It says, created man out of a mere clot, congealed blood. Listen.
Read that verse out.
Let me finish. It says, created man out of mere clot of congealed blood. That's Surah 96, verse 2. It says, we created man from sounding clay, clot then clay. Then it says, the multitude of Jesus before Allah is that Adam, he created him from dust. So clay, clot, and dust, he was created. So this God is schizophrenic because he don't know what he's talking about. Here it is. Let me finish. It says he has created man from a sperm drop. So it's clot, dust, sperm drop. That's 4 verses. I've read the Quran perfectly. Contradiction, bro.
You never answer my question. Tell me, did Michal have 5 sons? Or did she have no children up to her death? How many?
You would have to read the text.
Answer.
Read it to text. Read the text.
You read the text.
It's your point, you read it.
No, I read to you. I want you, a Christian, to hold your Bible
and read it. Your point.
Can you imagine a Christian not accepting the Bible?
It's your point, bro. It's your point. You read it.
I'm telling you, read it's your Bible. Why don't you read?
I read it.
It's time.
Okay.
Another one. Are there contradictions in your Bible?
No.
Yes or no?
No.
Let me give you another one. In the first book of Chronicles, chapter 18, verse 4, it says, and David took from him 1,000 chariots and 7 1,000 horsemen. But in the second book of Samuel, it says, and David took from him 1,000 chariots. So my question, how many horsemen did David take? 7,000, as first book of Chronicles says, or 700, as second book of Samuel says?
If you look at the Old Testament, there are Old Testaments in the Septuagint, Greek and in Hebrew. So sometimes there can be a mistake in the translation. So it's a mistake in the translation. Let me finish.
Why don't you read your Bible?
Let me finish.
So how many? 7,000 or 700?
I've explained it very clearly.
You haven't seen it.
It says here in Surah 2:256, let there be no compulsion in religion. And then it says in Surah 9:3, proclaim a grievous penalty to those who reject faith. So the contradiction. No compulsion, penalty if you reject faith.
And you are
historical Jesus. The Quran says Jesus did not die on a cross.
No.
We have historical evidence.
So
we have Thallus AD 52. We have Suetonius AD 69 to 140. Tacitus 56, 120. We have Lucian of Samosia, Celsus, Josephus, the Jewish Talmud, all say that Jesus died on a cross.
Are
so
you
the Quran
us?
Is not the word of God,
okay.
Because it's not historically reliable. Christ
okay.
is the greatest.
Okay. You just said that Jesus died, yes?
Yes, bro.
Are you telling us that God Almighty died?
Let me answer the question then. Can I ask you the question?
Yeah.
You believe the Quran came down through Gabriel, then to Muhammad, stick stones and bones, and then it was written on paper. Uthman burnt the paper. Listen, that doesn't burn. Listen. The eternal word became paper. The paper burnt. Doesn't destroy the word. Listen, Jesus is the eternal word, and when his body died, it didn't destroy God.
You are losing this debate. In the Gospel according to Matthew, chapter 6, verse 6, it says God, it talks about God who is unseen. In other words, God, nobody has seen him. My question, if Jesus was God, did the people see Jesus? Yes or no?
What he's on about is you can't see the full glory of God. You can't see the full glory of God.
No,
that's what he's on about.
Let me answer. Your Bible says no one has ever seen God.
Well, there are many verses. You've got to read many verses, bro.
Well, what about this word?
Let me finish.
What about this word?
Let me finish. The stoning verse of the adulterer in Sahih Muslim, volume 4, 4415, was lost. Okay?
All this propaganda.
Sunnah Ibn Majah, volume 3, 2553. It says he couldn't find the stoning verse. So there are missing verses in your Quran.
No, there are not. Our Quran is, excuse me.
Missing verses, bro.
Sir, no. Our Quran is one and the same. As far as missing the verses is concerned, did you know in your Bible there are missing books? You talk about missing verses. I have in our Quran no missing, but in your Bible there are missing books. How? Catholic Bible, 73 books. Your Protestant Bible, 66 books. So in your Protestant Bible, you have 7 books which are missing. Why? Because your Bible, 66 books. Protestant Bible, Catholic Bible, 73 books, and Orthodox Christian Bible, 81 books. So there you have the missing books, man.
The Protestant Bible, number one, Jesus in John chapter 14 said he would give the Holy Spirit.
What a missing?
Let me finish. The apostles had the authority to write. Now, early on in the church, Irenaeus, Polycarp, Origen, Tertullian, all these great early church fathers said that there was about 24 books that were the word of God. There was dispute about 3 or 4 books. okay?
In your Bible.
Yes, but they were accepted eventually by Athanasius and other councils.
Okay.
So all this saying that the lost, these are people that were not listening to what the Spirit of God was saying.
So answer my question. I said, Catholic Bible 73 books, Protestant Bible 66 books, Orthodox Bible 81 books. Which of these Bibles is the true Bible?
What I'm saying is the early church fathers, if you listen, Athanasius, Irenaeus, Polycarp, Ignatius, all quoted most of the New Testament, Origen. So the early church fathers, the books.
66 or 72.
There was an argument about three or four books. Now these were accepted eventually because the early church fathers, they didn't have the internet. They couldn't discuss like we do today.
Do you know Matthew?
But they were accepted eventually.
Tell me, if you take away 66 from 73, what is the number you get? 7. Yes? If you take away 66 from 73, what is the number? 7. So in other words, either you have taken away 7 books from the Bible, that's why your Bible has 66 books, or the Catholics, they have added 7 extra books.
Jerome said what was in the Word of God, and the Pope went over his head. The Pope was not listening. The Pope was not listening. The early church, if you listen, the early church quoted 24 of the books. There was discussion about a few of the books. Because if you listen and understand, the early church didn't have computers and the internet. It was not decided ultimately by a council. It was the Word of God that attests to itself. If you read the Apocrypha, if you read the Gnostic Gospels, for example, all quote the four Gospels. The Gnostic writers all quote the New Testament. The New Testament never quotes the Gnostic Gospels. What that tells you is the early church saw the New Testament as authoritative.
Did the German Martin Luther in the 16th century, did he take away 7 books from the Bible?
No. Let me
That's
answer.
Why you got
No, let me answer. No, he had a problem with the gospel. He had a problem with the book of James because it says about works. That's what he had a problem with. But Luther was not perfect. Luther was not a perfect person. Listen, the whole of the history of the church, right at the beginning, within the first 200 years, there was a clear demarcation of Paul's epistles and the gospels and some letters. It was very, very clear. Very, very clear. The Apocrypha came in because they're not the Word of God. They misunderstood. If you read those books, they're clearly not the Word of God, bro. Have you ever read the Gnostic Gospels?
Okay, excuse me.
Have you ever read the Gnostic Gospels?
Excuse me. You said...
Okay. Have you ever read the Gnostic Gospels?
I have read your Bible, okay? I even got one in my bag.
Have you read the Gnostic Gospels?
Okay, now listen. It is Martin Luther, a German, who in the 16th century took away the 7 books from your Bible. That's why. So if Martin Luther wasn't perfect, then why do you carry Martin Luther's Bible of 66 books?
First of all, you're making a claim that Martin Luther took away so many books. You've not provided any evidence, bro. Give us some detail. Give us some evidence. No, Luther, listen. Luther, I have a degree in it. Luther had an issue with the book of James because he said we're saved by grace, and James said about works, right? But it still was in the canon, my friend. Now it's my point now. My point, you made your point twice. We have a number of Qurans. We have the Hafs Quran and we have the Wash
Quran.
We have the Hash Quran and the Wash Quran. They're textual variants, they're not the same. Here's some words that are not the same.
Look at this. That's all propaganda.
In the Wash Quran, it says, they say, in Surah 2, 139, because the number
is
different.
Excuse me.
Listen.
No
listen.
Problem in
listen.
Our Quran.
Listen.
It is in the original
listen.
Arabic language.
Two Qurans.
You
two Qurans. The Wash and the half. They're different here in the language. Half, it says, you say. In the wash, it says, they say. In the half, it says, I gave you. In the wash, it says, we gave you. Surah 3, 38,
Excuse
80.
Me, are you talking about translation?
You got two Qurans there, bro.
Okay, no. Quran is
talking about translation.
Let me tell you, yeah, translation. About. Excuse me, the Quran is one and the same. The Quran was revealed in Arabic, and the Quran we still have in Arabic worldwide. Now, it is you people.
Okay.
Where is your original scripture?
Okay. I will concede.
Where is your original Bible?
I will concede now.
Well,
if he answers this question, I will concede and go home, and I will never come to this park again.
You have an answer.
Are you ready? The Quran was revealed on sticks, stones, and bones.
Leaves.
Sticks, stones, and bones, and leaves.
And leaves.
Give me the chain of narration for the sticks, stones, and bones, bro.
Excuse me, listen. The Quran.
Give it to me, bro.
Can I speak?
Come on now.
Allahu Akbar.
Jabal.
Hey,
Jesus.
But Jesus died. He was a powerful body.
Give me the chain of narration.
Okay,
the chain of narration for the sticks, stones, and bones.
Look, excuse me. You spoke about that before, and I answered you.
No.
What was revealed, I already told you. What was revealed to other Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him.
I will go home.
I will never debate. Because
the chain of narration for the sticks, stones, and bones.
Excuse me. I told you this.
End of debate. Game over.
Yeah, your game is over.
Game over.
You was never able to answer my question.
No, Gabriel give you a Bible.
Our original is
Gabriel
there.
Give you nothing wrong.
Everywhere, anywhere you go, the Quran is one and the same. It is your Bible.
It was a demon,
which I'm down.
That spoke it to
is,
Muhammad.
It is your Bible.
It's a demon that spoke to Muhammad.
You're acting like a
because
demon.
Because the sticks, stones, and bones.
You're acting like a demon.
Give me the chain of narration.
Allahu Akbar. Okay.
Give me the chain of narration.
Your body is like a demon. Yeah.
Give me the chain of narration.
He's acting like a double disciple.
Give me the chain of narration.
Okay, you're acting like a double disciple.
Don't attack me. Give me the chain of narration.
He keeps on talking. It's on camera.
Sticks, stones, and bones.
It's on the camera. The questions I asked him, he wasn't able to answer. I told you what was revealed to our Prophet Muhammad, peace upon him. He did not write it down, but it was written down on leaves, on bones, on stones. Okay, and later on, in book form, it was Zaid bin Sabit who was given the duty to write the Quran in book form. And how did he write? Not from himself, but he collected all the writings together. The Quran was memorized by the Muslims. And it was checked by those who memorized it. It is your Bible.
I've got it.
Where is the original Aramaic in your Bible?
Let me answer. The more manuscripts you have, the more you confirm your scripture. Yeah. Let me finish. We have 5,000 ancient manuscripts. That is a confirmation that we have the original text.
That's why we got different Bibles.
Let me finish.
Allahu Akbar.
They claim that their Quran came from Angel Gabriel to Prophet Muhammad. You say that, yeah?
It came from Allah.
And it came on sticks, stones, and and bone. I want to know.
It was written down.
Yeah, I want to know. I want to know. Number one, show me a stick, stone, and bone. And number two, give me the chain of narration.
From there.
And if you do that, I will go home.
Okay, listen. You can go home if you like. Why? The questions I asked you, you were not able to answer me. The number of sons which Michal had. One of your books said 5, the other said 0. No, you never answered it. Okay, the number of fighting men David had. One book said 7,000, the other book said 700. You never answered it. Yes, and you're asking us, Mr. Our Quran is in the original Arabic language. Okay, our Quran, pick it up anywhere, everywhere, any continent, any country, in the hands of a Muslim, in a public library, in a Muslim place of worship, in a masjid. The first surah is Surah Al-Fatiha. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Ar-Rahmanir Rahim. Maliki Yawmiddin. And the last surah in our Quran, everywhere, anywhere, is Surah number 114, Surah Al-Nas. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Kul a'uzu bi Rabbin Nas, Malikin Nas, Ilahin Nas. Okay, so there you are. But your Bibles, you have not been able to answer me why the different number of books in your Bible. How can there be 3 different type of Bibles and each one Orthodox Christian says Orthodox Bible with 81 books, that's the book of God. Catholic Christian says that the Catholic Bible with 73 books, that is the book of God. But you, a Protestant Christian, you say the Bible, Protestant Bible, with 66 books, that is the book of God. So you Christians, you are www.confused.com.
You quoted Luther. Luther says the Bible is the cradle where Christ is laid. And if you look at the beginning of the Bible and the end of the Bible, there is a golden thread. And that golden thread is about Jesus Christ. That's why, Let me finish. Luther said the Bible is the cradle where Christ is laid. So from the beginning to the end, it's all about Christ. Listen, it's a golden thread. That's why they're accepted as the Bible. That's why we don't accept every other book, because they're not about the true Christ. Okay? Now let me finish with you.
Do you believe in Jesus?
Yes, I do, yes.
You do? Do you believe he was God?
Yes, yes.
And do you believe as a Christian in your Bible?
Yes, yes.
And do you believe everything which Jesus said?
Yes.
Did Jesus create you?
Yes.
Did Jesus create the universe?
Yes.
As
did
a
Jesus
yes.
Quiet?
As a word, yes.
Quiet?
As a word, yes.
Shut up. Your father will speak when I finish.
You have made that question.
Okay.
Take it.
These Christians are terrorists.
Let them answer.
These are terrorists. Christian terrorists. Look at these Christians. Christ. What? I quote their God. They say Jesus is God. He says God. Okay. So Jesus said, by myself, I can. So, quiet, because he's suffering. So,
has anybody deaf here?
So,
yeah,
you're deaf to that.
By myself, we can do nothing.
So, when Jesus said, by myself, I can do nothing, how can he create anything? How? Second point, Jesus said, by him who sent me. If Jesus was God, who sent Jesus?
Can I finish now?
Yeah.
We're not Muslims. Muslims?
Answer.
We're Christians.
That's why you can't answer.
Listen, answer. I didn't interrupt you.
Keep quiet. Answer.
Right? We have to take all of Scripture. Now the Bible says in Philippians chapter 3,
John. John 5:30.
Let me finish.
You've been a hypocrite.
Listen.
John 5:30.
No, you love me.
I'm a Muslim.
No, you're not.
Don't tell me what's
happening,
okay?
Let me finish.
So, no, you are.
Yeah, but you tell him off, and you interrupt yourself.
Why are you just letting
you interrupt him?
I am saying...
You don't realize.
Just chill out. Let me ask.
Go on, answer. Don't go to people.
Christians automatically go to two passages.
Okay.
Answer. Philippians chapter 2, where it says, listen. It says, he thought it not robbery to be equal with God, but made himself of no reputation and humbled himself even to the death of the cross. So the answer is, he was God in eternity, but he became a man and he became a servant. So he's saying these questions as a servant. Now listen, let me finish. I'm not interrupted. Let me finish. So number one, servant. Number two, let me finish. It says in John chapter 1, verse 1, it says, in the beginning was the Word was with God, and the Word was God. Yeah. And then in verse 14, yeah, it said, and the Word became flesh.
Yeah.
Let me finish.
Let me finish.
When I go to the Quran, you expect me to look at the context, and you expect me to look at all the scriptures. When you're going to the Bible, you're just taking a few isolated texts.
Okay.
You take all the texts,
okay,
and it says that Jesus is God, he created everything, but when he became a man, listen, when he became a man, he was a servant. So he's speaking as a servant.
How can God become a servant?
That is the answer to your question.
The Word has taken a flesh.
How can God become a servant?
The Word has taken a flesh.
Make one last point. One last point, and then one last point. We end it now.
Yeah.
Okay, go. One last point.
Yeah. Okay.
Thank you for debating. Can you shake my hand?
Okay, yeah. Come on. Okay. Listen. African style.
Can you shake my hand?
You may have been eating.
Can you shake my hand? Bro, can you shake my hand?
I'm going to touch my Quran. Anyway, listen. In your Bible.
Give me a hug.
In your Bible. Excuse me, we are not gay. So don't tell me give you a hug. Okay? I know in churches you marry man with a man.
Give us a hug, come on now.
And they hug each other in the church.
I'm getting married
on
the 18th.
But we are Muslim.
To a woman.
We don't believe in homosexuality.
So
why do you hug each other on Eid Day? Why do you hug each other on Eid Day?
Let your preacher father.
If you are not gay, then why do you hug each other on Eid Day? Why do you do that? Why do you do that? So this means you are a hypocrite.